Shepherd Who Would Not Go by Haywood Brown. The host of heaven and the angel of the Lord had filled the sky with radiance. Now they were gone as shepherds and sheep stood under the dim starlight. The men were shaken by the wonders they had seen and heard, and like the animals, they huddled close. "Let us go to Bethlehem," said the eldest shepherd, "and see this which the Lord hath made known to us." The city of David lay beyond a far, high hill. Above was the bright, shining star. The men made haste to be away, but one, Amos, dug his crook into the turf and clung to it. "Come," cried the eldest shepherd, "it was an angel. You heard the tidings. A Savior is born." Amos shook his head. "I heard," he said, "but I will abide." The eldest walked over to Amos, saying, "You do not understand. An angel commanded us. We go to worship the Savior in Bethlehem. God has made his will manifest." "It is not in my heart," replied Amos. Now the eldest shepherd was angry. "With your own eyes," he cried out, "you have seen the host of heaven, and you heard when glory to God in the highest came ringing out of the night." Another shepherd broke in. "Because the hills still stand and the sky is not fallen, it's not enough for Amos. He must have something louder than the voice of God." Amos leaned on his crook and answered, "I have need of a whisper." They laughed and asked, "What should this voice say in your ear? Tell us. What says the God of Amos, little shepherd of 100 sheep?" Meekness fell away from Amos. He took his hands from off the crook and raised them high. "I too am a God," he said in a loud, strange voice. "And to my 100 sheep, I am a Savior." And when the din of the angry shepherds around him slackened, he pointed to his 100. "See my flock. The fear of the bright angel and heavenly voices is still upon them. God is busy in Bethlehem. He has no time for 100 sheep. I will abide." This the others did not take so much amiss. There was terror among the flocks, and the shepherds knew the ways of sheep. Before leaving, each shepherd told Amos what to do for the care of the several flocks. And yet, before they reached the road leading to Bethlehem, one or two turned back to taunt him. "We shall see new glories at the throne of God, and you, Amos, will see sheep." Amos paid no heed, but thought, "One less shepherd will not matter at the throne of God." Nor did he have time to be troubled that he was not to see the child. There was much to be done. Amos walked among the sheep, making a clucking noise, a way he had, and to his 100 and to the others, it was a sound more soothing and friendly than the voice of the bright angel. Presently, the animals ceased trembling and began to graze as the sun came up over the hill where the star had been. "For sheep," said Amos to himself, "the angels shine too much. A shepherd is better." With morning, the shepherds returned from Bethlehem. They told Amos of the manger and the wise men who had mingled there with them. They described the gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. When they were finished, they asked, "And did you see wonders here in the fields with the sheep?" Amos replied, "Now my 100 are 101. And he showed them a lamb that was born just before the dawn. out of heaven? Asked the eldest of the shepherds. Smiling, Amos shook his head, and there was upon his face what seemed to the shepherds another wonder, even in a night of wonders. To my heart, he said, there came a whisper.